Alrighty, what is going on, everybody? Of course, my name is Blitzwinger, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another LEGO review. Today, we're going to be taking a look at one of the brand new LEGO movie sets that has just been released, and I guess it's a tie-in for 2015, I believe, at least. I managed to get my hands on this a little bit earlier, actually, so that was awesome. Just didn't get around to making a review because I was a little sick. Nonetheless, with all those excuses out of the way, let's, of course, take a look at the beautiful packaging for set number 70818, the double-decker couch, of course, a pretty important moment in the LEGO movie film. And, of course, if you haven't seen it, I'm not going to spoil why it is very important, but it definitely played a pretty important part in the film indeed. So it looks like this set contains 5 minifigures, which is really surprising because I really am not used to a set this small containing that many minifigures. So that's really, really cool. We have got the Ghost of Vitruvius, which is awesome, President Business, Benny, and, of course, oh my god, how could I forget his name? Emmett. And then, of course, Kitty as well. Nice Kitty. Was that her name? Nice Kitty? No, it was something Kitty. Oh my god, how could I forget the name? Nonetheless, with that being said, we also get a double-decker couch and the vehicle, so that looks absolutely awesome. 197 pieces in total. By the way, her name is Unikitty. How could I forget? Right there. Bam! Unikitty, Present Business, Ghost Retrievius, Benny, and Emmett. Ay, caramba, I need to rewatch the movie, because I can't believe I forgot her name. I'm sorry, Unikitty. Ooh, that's a waffle. Mmm, that sounds tasty. All right, on the back, we have a nice, a beautiful shot of all the different things assembled fully. We also have some of the play features. I guess the vehicle roof opens up, and the doors also will open side to side. With that being said, let's go on ahead and open the setup, assemble it, and take a look at all the goodies, shall we, guys? so we kick things off with the spookiest of the minifigures in the set, and that is, of course, the Ghost Vitruvius. And as you can see, it is a glow-in-the-dark piece, which is absolutely awesome. I love that. That is super-duper spooky-looking and very, very cool indeed. But let there be light! Alright, so with that being said, here is the minifigure itself, of course, upon adding the light. Of course, as you saw during the assembly process, the inside of the figurine is just a white plain body, no print work on there. There is print work on this little piece right down here, but the head is also just a plain black piece as well, so there's no particular details there. And then, of course, he has that beautiful, glorious, shiny cape going for him, which is absolutely awesome. Next up after that, we have, of course, the one and only Lord Business. And he looks, or President Business, I should say, because he's not in his Lord form. But he looks pretty awesome. I really love the new print work on the faces, of course. That looks incredibly cool. I love the unibrow going on there. So he's got a happy expression. And then, of course, if we rotate that around, he's got kind of not an angry expression necessarily, but kind of a confused expression as if he's like, what is going on here? Which is awesome. So that will be really, really handy for people who do stop motions and such. I'm sure they'll put that to good use. But that is absolutely fantastic. Love that print work, and he looks absolutely great. Speaking of new expressions or new print work, of course, as you can see, we have a brand new expression for Emmett, which looks absolutely terrific. I love it, of course. Looks really, really neat. Other than that, of course, he looks very similar to the previous figurines that we've gotten of Emmett, so nothing new in that department to speak of course. All of the same print work on the torso, the little card right there. He does come with a delicious-looking waffle. I could totally go for that. That looks quite tasty indeed. But additionally to his one expression right here, you can go ahead and turn his head on over to a more confused-like expression right there. So if you want, you could obviously go ahead and display him like so. Or maybe it's actually even more upset than confused. I'm not 100% certain. Can't quite pinpoint it greatly, but it looks kind of as if he's maybe even kind of betrayed or something, sad. It's kind of hard to pinpoint, but it's really cool to get another expression for Emmett, especially considering we've gotten so many Emmett figures that it's really nice to get a different expression for him. Now, additionally, if you saw during the build process, in his vehicle, he comes with a little hard hat, so you could go ahead and display him that way as well. The only issue with that is that, of course, you don't have the hairpiece on the sides, and more importantly, on the back of the character, you're going to be able to see his face, which is kind of spooky, because, of course, it'd be kind of weird to see another face on a person's head, because yeah, that's just kind of weird. So luckily, when you have him wearing his hairpiece, you won't be able to see that on the back there because it covers it right up. Alrighty, so next up, not necessarily a minifigure, I know, not by classical definition, because, well, you know, technically, usually a minifigure would be more like this, where we're kind of used to a certain shape and structure to a minifigure. But this is, of course, the one, the only Unikitty, whose name I forgot before, which was really embarrassing. But nonetheless, I really love what they did this time around. Of course, we have her in a sitting pose. There are some really nice details to her, like, for example, her tail right there obviously looks really cool. But the thing that I really, really enjoyed more so than anything was the fact that they went ahead and gave even her two different expressions. Now, it does take a little bit of finagling, and it does take a little bit more work than it would with another minifigure. Basically, what they did is they made another expression, and what you have to do is you have to take the horn off, then you have to take the ears off, then, after that, sorry, I don't want to mess this up. All right, we're going to take the other, nope, the other ear, please, thank you. That is really kind. All right, and then last but certainly not least, you need this white piece, the 1x3, off, and there you go. So now you've got a completely different expression for her. Now, additionally to that, of course, as you can see, the eyebrow print work is actually two different pieces. So if you want, you could mix and match those as well. So that's really cool, and I think that it gives it, again, an extra bit of value, and it just looks really neat. I really like it. I think it's a really, really smart decision on their part, because, again, the more display options you get, the better in my book. And last but certainly not least, personally for me, the minifigure I was looking forward to the most is the one and only Mr. Spaceship Benny. So, nonetheless, of course, I don't own a Benny figure, so I was really excited to get one. And more importantly, there were some really cool things that I was looking forward to seeing on the figure. So, first of all, I guess his accessory is a hot dog, because I guess they're having a movie night and they're watching a movie, and he decided to eat a hot dog during the movie, which is kind of weird. But there were some details that I really was looking forward to see, like the kind of wear and tear that there would be on this figure. So, of course, as you can see, we see some really lovely details, like the missing visor piece, and the way that they went about creating the broken piece is really cool because it's actually not broken, but it's sculpted to look as though it is. So I really love that. I think his expression is awesome, absolutely glorious. Like, that defines to me the Lego movie right there. That expression is probably what I look like through most of the movie whenever I end up watching it. So yeah, anytime I watch it, that's most likely how I look, which is kind of scary because I really hope my mouth is not that big. Nonetheless, of course, there's also some really good wear and tear on this, which looks really neat. The spaceship effect, so that's really, really cool, or print work, I should say. And then on the back, of course, we've got the little tanker right here. Now, his helmet is removable, and he also does have another expression, just like all the other characters, which is pretty cool. So he's got this kind of more nervous expression, or maybe when they kept telling him, "No, Benny, not now. We're not going to build the spaceship now." That's probably a perfect expression right there to summarize that, which, again, still adorable and still absolutely awesome. So with that being said, let's go on ahead and take a look at the two builds in this set. Alrighty guys, so here is, of course, the fully assembled vehicle part of this set. As you can see, it looks quite nice indeed. I got one of those rotating tables, so now I can actually not constantly touch the design, but I can actually showcase it like this, which is pretty nice indeed. Of course, as we saw on the back of the packaging, the main features of this is the ability to remove the roof, and then of course go ahead and place Mr. Emmett in the actual driver's seat. Of course, you could place any other minifigure that you would like, of course, standard sized one that is. And we also do have opening doors on both sides of the vehicle, which is pretty nice, as well as a little bit of a storage unit right there for Emmett's hard hat. And of course, you then would try to close this. For some reason, it doesn't want to close. I think you might have to remove his hair piece, actually. Oh, nope, there we go. We're in. Everything is good. So there's Emmett driving to work, singing, of course, "Everything is awesome," which he can actually do because there's a little bit of a little radio piece right there which reads radio. So it's pretty funny. I like that. It just says radio. That's it. That's all it is. It doesn't have any type of channel or actual radio station. It's just radio. So nonetheless, that is the car right here. It rolls quite nicely as well, which is pretty cool. Indeed, as you can see, very, very smooth. So that's really cool. And with that in mind, let's go on ahead and take a look at what the set is all about, and that is the Double Decker Couch. Alrighty guys, so here is the Double Decker Couch itself, fully assembled. It was an absolute blast to actually build this thing. It was really, really fun. I love the way that this whole thing comes together. Quite cool indeed. And of course, out of it, you get a really funny and at the same time cool display piece of the Double Decker Couch itself. I really, really like this thing quite a bit. One little nitpick that I don't particularly care for is this, the ladders right here. As you can see, they kind of bend outwards, which is a bit unfortunate, especially because most of the pictures that we see on the packaging and such actually show these flat with the surface. So maybe it would have taken one more extra piece or something to extend this outwards, because I think that would have really, really helped it stand out maybe more straight. So that's a bit of a negative right there. But other than that, as you can see, it can definitely hold four characters at once, including Unikitty if you would like. So that's pretty awesome. So let's go ahead and remove the characters real quick just so we could take a look at the couch itself in a more comprehensive manner. Oh, you dropped your waffle, sir. There you go. He's gonna have that later on. But nonetheless, of course, you can see four cup holders, which is pretty handy as well. There's the little pegs for sitting. And of course, you don't have to actually peg the characters. You can go ahead and actually sit them on the flat pieces as well. It's just that then you have to be a little bit concerned, because if you move it around, of course, the character is gonna slide out of place, which is a bit of a negative. But other than that, I really like the colorization. I think the blue maybe could have been a little bit of a darker blue, because that's kind of how I recall it to be in the actual film. I might be wrong about that, but I don't remember it being such a baby blue. I think it could have been a little bit of a darker hue of blue to really make it look more accurate. But other than that, really, really cool design, and I am super duper happy with it. Alrighty guys, so there you guys have it. That was the Double Decker set review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed assembling this, certainly enjoyed getting all these cool minifigures into my collection, and I am super duper glad with the way that the Double Decker couch and the little car right here turned out. Very much looking forward to seeing and reviewing some more of the cool new LEGO Movie sets. Stay tuned, I'm planning to do one for Let's Build, so stay tuned for that. It's a really cool set that actually features the one and only the Dark Knight himself, so stay tuned for that. It'll be really, really fun indeed. With that being said, thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, please don't forget to hit that like button. A lot of work went into this one. It took me a while because I kept failing at a couple parts, so yeah, that would really help me out a ton. Share the videos with your family and friends, favorite the videos as well, and I will, of course, catch you guys here next time. Peace out, see you laters, alligators. Bye-bye, guys, thanks all for watching.